Well, hello there, RPK Online. Ah, oh, don't you just love springtime? The grass is green and the leaves are coming back on the trees. Oh, it is a great time to dig in the dirt and do some gardening. I'm Jen, and I just love working outside with the worms and bugs and veggies and flowers. Do any of you have a garden at your house or in your neighborhood? Cool. What have you planted? That's awesome. Oh, I can't wait for my garlic and my lettuce and tomatoes to start growing. And then I have this. I'll show you later. Anyway, it's so fun to plant seeds and then watch your garden grow. And this month, we're here to talk about a way we can grow. With God's help, we can grow in humility. Humility is putting others first by giving up what you think you deserve. It's not easy to put others first. Usually we want to be first, or we want to have things our way. Like if you're playing video games with your friend and they want to play a different game, it's hard to let them get their way instead of insisting on playing the game you want to play. But humility is all about putting others first to show them how much you care about them. When you're humble, you, basic truth, treat others the way you want to be treated. We'll hear a lot this month about the one who gave us the perfect example of humility. That's right, I am talking about Jesus. Friends, I am so excited to dig into some great stories this month as we see how Jesus showed humility. Remember, humility is all about putting others first, and that is certainly what Jesus did for us. We've already looked at some amazing stories about Jesus. How he taught people about God, healed people who were sick, and performed miracles. Jesus spent his time showing people God's love in a new and powerful way. And today's story is another example of that. Let's worship together and then watch.
And now it's time for this month's widget with MC Haggis and Seamus McFamous.
He's right again. Hey? Boy, that guy is 1,029 for 1,029.
Oh, hey there, I'm MC Haggis, and this here is Seamus McFamous, and we're here to show you this month's widget. Show it to him, Seamus. It's the community garden fidget. Now, it might look like an ordinary pea pod, but you won't be able to put this fidget down.
Hey!
Hey! Families can put others first by taking turns working the fidget while discussing the included questions about how we can be more humble in our everyday lives. So get yours today! So what made you scream? Oh! The bee comes out of the pea pod.
Yeah.
That's pretty clever.
1, 2, 3, 2, 1, 3, 1, 2, 1.
Hi, RPK. Our basic truth this weekend is I can trust God no matter what. And that gives us about a million reasons to thank him. So stand up, let's do it.
Thank you, God, for saving me.
Thank you, God, for saving me.
Rescue from the middle of the ocean deep.
Rescue from the middle of the ocean deep.
You set my feet on solid ground.
You set my feet on solid ground.
I once was lost, but now I'm found.
I once was lost, but now I'm found.
Everything I have, I owe it all to you. For everything you are and all you do, Lord, I could write a book, fill every single page with a million reasons to thank you, Lord.
Oh, 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 oh,
for all you've done.
Thank you, God, for all you've done.
You gave your one and only son.
Okay, our bottom line today is this: Jesus put others first. And of course, that includes all of us. You know, his love is so great. It's like a waterfall rushing down on us. Come on, let's sing Waterfall. Yes, Lord Jesus, your love is so amazing. It never ends. It never stops. And what a great picture for us to imagine a waterfall just washing over us constantly. constantly. Thank you so much for that amazing love of yours. Thank you that you put others first. And because of that, we can do that too. We can also put others first. Thank you so much for who you are and what you have done for us. We just love you more than we could ever even imagine. And it's in your loving name that we pray today. Amen.
There you go.
Thank you.
Hey, welcome to the Story Lab. This week we're talking about humility while we take a look at the story of someone really important who took on the job of a servant. Hey, I'm Carter.
And I'm Zeke.
We're talking about humility.
Which is putting others first by giving up what you think you deserve.
I think you should go first and tell everyone what we're doing today.
Oh, I couldn't possibly. You first.
No, you.
You.
This is ridiculous.
Agreed.
So you want to tell everyone what we're doing?
Well, there's an amazing celebration coming up next week.
Spoiler alert, Easter.
And one of the traditional ways to celebrate new life at Easter is by decorating these tasty semi-orbs.
Today, we're going to get creative.
We've each found a new way to decorate eggs.
And you can decide what you like best.
You may go first.
Thank you, but your way has to dry first. So you first.
Oh, it's fine. Did you just win at being humble?
Let's
make it. I'm using shaving cream. Step one, fill a baking sheet with shaving cream and smooth it out. Step two, drip food coloring all over the cream. Lots of food coloring. Then swirl it around with a toothpick. Step three is the really fun part. You're gonna need gloves for this. Take a hard-boiled egg and roll it all around in the shaving cream. Make sure they're completely covered. When you're done, let them dry for 20 minutes and you can do a bunch of different colors. Voila!
Okay, so those may turn out kinda cool, but while they dry, let's try my way. Okay, step one is super simple. Just dye your eggs a solid color in the regular way, using hot water, food color, and vinegar. Now we get to the fun part. Step two, fill a small bowl or container with an inch of fresh water. Now, choose the color that you want to marbleize your egg with. It should be darker than the color of the solid egg, so use a lot of food coloring. Step three, add 1 tablespoon of olive oil and stir it gently to create swirls and bubbles. Step four, take the solid color egg and place it in the oily water. Roll it around with a spoon and hold it in place for a few seconds here and there to absorb more color. The longer you roll your egg around, the more marbled it will be. You know what, now I wanna take them out and kinda just mix up the colors and just try to see where that goes. Eggs are gonna look very good.
Mine are gonna look better.
Are they dry?
I think so.
Want some help?
Sure. It's like an archaeological dig.
What lies beneath?
Ooh. That is pretty.
Look at this.
You're Your eggs are very marbly.
And your eggs are very swirly.
What do we do with them now?
They're just for decoration.
Maybe an egg throwing contest?
Or not. It's time for
the story before the story.
Today, we're in John, the fourth book in the New Testament. But before John, in the very beginning, out of a deep, deep love, God made an amazing world. But when people turned away from God, the world was broken.
God made a plan to draw people back into relationship. So at the right time, God sent a tiny baby to be born in the small town of Bethlehem, God's very own son, Jesus.
When Jesus grew up, he began to travel from town to town, teaching and healing.
At last, he made his way toward Jerusalem for the Passover feast.
Which is where our story starts.
Take it away.
Hey, everyone. I'm Brian. Jesus was about to head into Jerusalem, where great crowds were gathered for the Passover feast. He asked two of his disciples to bring him a donkey and her colt. They placed their coats across the colt to make a comfortable seat for him. Now, Bethany, where Jesus was staying, was only a short distance from Jerusalem. Jesus had walked hundreds of miles on foot. So why did he need a donkey for a measly 2 miles? Well, great kings often rode victoriously on a powerful war horse. But Jesus knew what the prophet Zechariah had written long ago.
Say to the city of Zion, see, your king comes to you. He is gentle and riding on a donkey. He is riding on a donkey's colt.
Jesus was showing that he was a different kind of king, a king who came to serve rather than to order people around. As the people saw him coming, they laid their coats on the ground and cut branches from palm trees. They called out,
Hosanna! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord! Hosanna! Hosanna!
News about Jesus and the amazing things he had done spread all through the city of Jerusalem. But the religious leaders had been looking for a way to get rid of him and saw their chance. Jesus knew the plans of the religious leaders. He knew the time had come for him to give up his life. But first, he had a special message for his closest friends. As they ate the Passover meal together, Jesus stood up. He took off his outer robe and wrapped a towel around his waist. Then he poured water into a bowl and knelt down to wash his disciples' feet. The disciples must have been surprised, to say the least. Washing feet was a dirty job saved for the lowliest servant. Yet Jesus, who had just been hailed as a king, was washing their feet. When Jesus reached Peter, though, Peter put up a protest.
Lord, are you going to wash my feet?
You don't realize now what I'm doing, but later you will understand. When Jesus finished washing their feet, he put on his outer robe and took his seat again. I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, so you also should wash one another's feet. I have given you an example. You should do as I have done for you. Now you know these things, so you will be blessed if you do them. Jesus, God's very own son, chose to take on the role of a humble servant, and he asked his followers to do the same. The end.
Honestly, the washing feet part kind of weirds me out.
Yeah, it does seem kind of odd to us now, but with walking dusty, dirty roads, washing feet when you arrived at somebody's home was super important.
Yeah, but Jesus didn't actually mean for us to go around taking off people's shoes and washing their feet, right?
Well, that's just one way Jesus put others first. The important thing Jesus wanted us to hear is that we can set aside our own wants and needs to show love to others.
So, what's our part in the story?
Well, maybe it's your brother's turn to unload the dishwasher, but you choose to do it for him.
Or you can tell your teacher is feeling really overwhelmed, so you use your free time to help clean up the classroom.
Last week, I got this brand new game I was super excited to play. But then my dad got home with a giant load of mulch to spread on the flower beds. So I put off playing my game to help him.
Yeah. See, if you keep your eyes open, there are opportunities all throughout your day to put others first.
And you don't actually have to wash their feet to do it.
That's good, right? I'll see you next time.
Here's the thing. Jesus put others first.
So what are we gonna do with these?
Well, my aunt is Greek, and they do this thing where they hold the egg like this. You do one too.
Okay.
Then you say, Christos Anesti.
What's that?
It means Christ is risen, and then you tap the eggs together. The egg that doesn't crack wins.
Let's do it.
Christos Anesti.
Ooh.
I win. Your egg just cracked.
My turn.
All right, ready? Whoa, 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 whoa! Tap, not smash.
Sorry, can we try again?
Sure. Thanks for joining us in the Story Lab.
See you next time.
All right, ready?
Ready.
I love that story. Jesus took on a chore that nobody wanted to do by washing the dirty, stinky, and probably all around disgusting feet of his disciples. This was a job that nobody who was considered important would ever be asked to do. But Jesus was showing a different way of treating people. Jesus showed what it looked like to put others first. He showed his disciples what can happen when we give up what we deserve. What Jesus did for them is such a powerful example for you and me today. Jesus, God's very own son, chose to take on the role of a lowly servant and wash the feet of his disciples. Jesus showed his followers that it's important to put others first and show true humility. It's important for us to live that way too. And that is our bottom line today. Jesus put others first. Like Jesus, we can also put aside what we want in order to show love to others. And if you look around, you'll see opportunities everywhere to show humility to the people in your life. Maybe at home, you could help your parents or siblings with chores without being asked. And before you do what you want to do. Maybe at school, you could choose to miss out on some fun recess time to sit with your friend who seems to be having a tough day. There are opportunities all through the day to put others first. I bet you can think of some great ideas, and I'd love for you to share them with your family later today. Before we finish up, let's look at our memory verse for this month. It's Philippians 2:3. These words from Paul will help us remember what it means to live with humility. Don't do anything only to get ahead. Don't do it because you are proud. Instead, be humble. Value others more than yourselves. Philippians 2:3. Let's say that together. Don't do anything only to get ahead. Don't do it because you are proud. Instead, be humble. Value others more than yourselves. Philippians 2:3. Did you catch that? Value others more than yourselves. We can show people how important they are by putting them first. And we should follow the example Jesus gave us. So let's pray and talk to God about that. Oh, dear God, this was such an amazing act of humility that Jesus showed to his friends. Please help us to choose to put others first, just like Jesus did. Help us show others that they are important to us the way we treat them. Give us the strength to follow your way because we know we can trust you no matter what. We love you, and we pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Doesn't it feel amazing when someone puts you first? So let's keep that in mind as we go through our week and look for others that we can put first. I'll see you next time. I am so excited. This kit, I have soil and I have seeds.